Good morning, everyone. P. Moody, and today's video is Back to the Heart of Worship. Let's start off in prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thou art the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Okay, so I was in my time of prayer and worship, and I was trying to hear what the Lord was saying, so I just started writing stuff down, and then he said, no, that's not what I'm saying. It was two things, so he pointed me to the other thing, which happens to be this video, Back to the Heart of Worship. Then he pointed me to the scriptures that I should write down pertaining to these very things. As we go through it, we'll discover that prayer and worship these days have become like a drive-through. It's just so quick or so fast, or, you know, we're rushing through. We're not sitting at the feet of the Father and really taking that time personal and taking it in. Remember that God does not want your prayer, your praise, your worship, your time with Him to be grudging. He wants it to be sparingly. He wants you to generously give. He wants you to want to be there and not feel forced to be there. But let's look at some scriptures. I have my head covered because as I was going back to the heart of worship, he reminded me, and I said, well, Lord, are we supposed to cover our heads? Because, you know, with the New Testament, you know, that not that these things are as they were before in the past, but I just feel that I feel a sense of connecting how it was back then, when they reverenced Him in spirit and in truth, and they had simple things, and they, you know, really reverenced God. Not that I'm saying you have to be led by how He leads you to do it, but I felt led to cover my head, and it's in 1 Corinthians 11. As that it says a woman dishonors her head. And I don't want to dishonor the Lord. I don't know if it's right or if it's wrong. I'm still learning what thus saith the Lord. I know Jesus Christ died for us and we are saved by grace and no longer by the law. But I want to make sure that I'm still in right standing with Him. So just to be on the safe side, I'm just covering my head going forward. In previous videos, I have not, but I've had on units and pieces. So I guess it is covering, but I wanted to formally just cover my head on today as I was praying. It says to pray when you prophesy, you cover your head. So that's what I was doing. But getting into the video today on Back to the Heart of Worship. So let's look at the scriptures. John 4, 23 through 24. John 4, 23 through 24. And I'm going to find it. And it reads, excuse me, the lighting in here is not that great. But the time is coming. Indeed, it's now here when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. The Father is looking for those who will worship Him that way. For God is spirit, so those who worship Him must worship in spirit and in truth. Then the next one is it's Exodus 3, 1 through 6. Exodus 3, 1 through 6, and I'll turn to it as well. Exodus 3, and it's 1 through 6. Some of you may be familiar with this, and some of you may not be, but it's Exodus 3, 1 through 6. Okay, and it reads, one day Moses was tending to the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, and the priest of Midian, he led the flock far into the wilderness and came to Sinai, the mountain of God. There, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a blazing fire from the middle of the bush. Moses stared in amazement. Though the bush was engulfed in flames, it didn't burn up. This is amazing, Moses said to himself. Why isn't the bush burning up? I must go and see it. When the Lord saw Moses coming to take a closer look, God called to him from the middle of the bush, Moses, Moses. Here I am, Moses replied. Do not come any closer. The Lord warned, take off your sandals, for you are standing on holy ground. I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. When Moses heard this, he covered his face because he was afraid to look at God. Look at that. When he realized he was in the presence of the Lord our God, that he was standing on holy ground, the Lord told him, God said, take off your sandals. You are standing on holy ground. There was a reverence there. There was a deep respect that you can't just walk around on this place that I am with how you normally do in any other area or any other atmosphere. You are standing on holy ground. So he told him, because he needed him to demand him his respect. It was due. And Moses obeyed quickly and did exactly as he said. He was in awe. He was in amazement. If we can only get back to that and not worry about what we look like when we're worshiping or what others think we're looking like, and trying to put on the appearance of being holy and actually be holy and just focus on the Lord our God and reverence him in all his glory and all his majesty, then we begin to truly understand what that worship truly looks like in our hearts and our spirits, with the relationship that he is in us, we are in him, that as we draw near to him, he will draw near to us. Let's just get back to kneeling on our feet and not find, if you're physically able, to get back to that and not find a robbery where, oh, I'm just going to stand, I'm just going to do a little bit of this. Why not? If you can do it, if he gives you the authority and the power and the strength to do it in your arms, your legs, your mouth, speak, then worship him out loud. Praise him. Give him the glory. Get on your feet. Kneel on your knees. Whatever it is, if you got to get a pillow, then get a pillow. But let's get back to the heart of worship, deep reverencing him as the people of the old did, even though we are the people of the new. But still, he is the same God, and let's reverence him that way. God bless you all. Pete Moody.